So the last time we discussed neural Turing machines. So just a small recap. I'm not going to again write the formula, but okay. So neural Turing machines are the first important point to remember is they are end-to-end differentiable. So that means you can apply stochastic gradient descent and other optimization techniques like this to reach a global minima, to reach a minima. So it's differentiable because the authors have defined bloody read and write operations, which I discussed in the last session. So there are read and write operations, and so essentially there are n memory locations, and each memory location has a weight. So for ith memory location, you have a weight W. Okay. And one important thing that I forgot to mention in the last session was, so the diagram went like this. So this is the controller. You read, write. This is the sort of external memory. You get the input. And the output. So this is the essential abstract diagram of neural Turing machine. So one important thing that I forgot to mention was that the controller is actually a neural network. Can be a feedforward neural network. Can be LSTM. Can be any neural network, essentially. So, and so there are many parameters that can be tweaked in a neural Turing machine. One is the number of read and write heads. So instead of having just one head, you can have two of them. Second is number of memory locations, which essentially means size of the memory matrix. And third is the architecture of the controller. So the authors, so if you are using an LSTM as a controller, the authors compare the internal memory of an LSTMs have internal memory as well. So they compare the internal memory of LSTMs to the registers in our CPU. That's what they do. Yeah, and one more parameter is range of allowed location shifts. This means that if these are, say, 0, 1, these are end memory locations, then if you are here, then by how much do you want the pointer to shift in across the memory location? So that also you can define, and that is a parameter. Okay, so now let's go to the application section. Just see if I'm missing anything. Okay. So their aim is to see how an external memory is more beneficial as compared to that compared to internal memory that an LSTM possesses. So they make comparisons among three architectures. One is simple LSTM. I'll tell you the tasks that they do, but they make comparisons primarily among these three architectures. So one is LSTMs. Another is this NTM with LSTM controller. And the third is NTM with feedforward neural network controller. Fully connected controller. So yeah, they make comparisons among these three architectures primarily, and the tasks that they do on so copying, repeated copying, being associative pointing. Associative recall. The other is estimation of n-gram probability distribution. And I think the last one is priority sort. So, okay. So the output activation function that they use is sigmoid. So all their inputs are essentially binary inputs, zeros and ones, and their outputs are sigmoid outputs. You apply the sigmoid function so that the means lie between 0 and 1. And the optimization that they use is RMS prop. If you ask me to explain RMS prop, I won't be able to right now because I'm not very thorough with it right now. So, and the momentum, I think, value that they use is 1.
Zero point nine.
And for different tasks, they use different number of read and write heads. And if they're using LSTM, they use different number of hidden layers and hidden units. So all that specification is given in the paper. And the loss that they use is cross entropy loss. So this is like the basic architecture, and they have specified the number of hidden units, number of read and write heads for each of these architectures. I think that section 4.6 they mentioned in this. So I'll just explain the task and the results that they obtain. There are some things that I have also not understood myself, but let's see. Okay. So, copying is essentially what they do is they train the network with 8-bit vectors and they vary the sequence length between 1 and 20. So, this is the input that they give.
One.
So this is the input that they give. One thing that they mention is that they introduce the input with a delimiter flag. But when they mention the target, it's the same as the vector that they get as the input, but they do it without a delimiter flag. I didn't really understand the reason behind it. Okay, so this is the input that they give while copying, and this is the target that they give. NTNs with LSTM and NTNs with feedforward neural network controller prove to be better than LSTMs. One more thing that they experimented with is that whether NTNs can generalize beyond the sequence length that they have given as input. So for example, they tested with sequences of less than tested with sequence lengths of 10, 20, 30, 50, 120. So the LSTMs were very poor in generalizing this copy algorithm beyond the training sequence length, but the NTNs were very good at it. So they hypothesized that the NTN is essentially learning a copy algorithm. They have actually given a pseudocode also. Pseudocode money, they have given it in simple language, like how they feel the network is learning. So they hypothesize that this copy algorithm, essentially the NTM is learning this. So they receive an input. So the network receives an input. It creates a head, and then it receives other parts of the input, and it starts incrementing by one until it encounters a delimiter flag. And then it encounters a delimiter flag. It returns this pointer back to the head location, and while emitting the output, it basically iterates through this, starting from the head because it's already at the head. So this is the algorithm that the authors say that the network has learned. So this is copying. Repeated copying is essentially what they want to see is that if your network has learned a routine which is inside a loop. So if you have a for loop and you have a subroutine here, and if your network has learned this subroutine, then it should be able to repeat it a certain number of times. So they again reported that these perform better than LSTMs. In every experiment, they see whether the network can generalize beyond the limit set on the training data. So here what they do is, as input, they say give a vector and the number of times they want it to be repeated. So I think they treated it, max sequence length in case of training was 10, I guess, and number of repetitions was also 10, but then they try to see if the NTN can generalize beyond this, so they doubled the sequence length and they tried with a combination of 20 and 10 once, and 10 and 20 once. So this is another task. Repeat copying. There are many specifications, I'm skimming over them. Now the authors saw that NTN can perform well by iterating over linear structures, but another data structure that they wanted to explore is when things point to one another. Instead of being in a linear structure, so the task that they wanted, so associative recall is the task where they give, the system a list of things and they want this, and on querying supposing this thing in the list, they want the system to output the next thing in the list. So this is the task of associative recall. Just a second. Yeah, this is the task of associative recall. So almost in all the tasks, I won't be repeating it again and again, almost in all the tasks, both of these were performing better than NSTMs. I think there was one task in which this was performing specifically better. There's some reason for it. Just a second. In case of associative recall, NTM with feed forward neural network was performing better than NSTMs, but I can't remember the reason. Okay, so another is estimation of n gram probability distribution. So they want to see whether another is estimation of n-gram probability distribution. Yeah, I think it's clear by the name itself. So, so what they do is they feed n-grams, binary n-grams, binary n-grams meaning not bigram, but yeah, binary n-grams meaning that each character was a binary, was 0 or 1. So, yeah, they wanted to see if the network would learn the probability distribution. So here, I think the network could not learn. I think there's a closed form solution to this, to the probability distribution. Oh, I can write the formula, but I've not really understood the formula myself. I tried understanding it, but okay, I'm not right at all. Not able to explain it. Okay, so basically, a probability, an optimal, there's a closed solution. For the optimal probability distribution, this probability distribution. So, yeah, so again, they saw that NTMs were better at approximating this probability distribution than LSTMs, but LSTMs were also performing well. And the last one is priority sort. So what they do is they input vectors, but this time they input vectors only. So V1, V2, Vn, but this time they attach some scalar values to it. So supposing this is 5, this is 2. I think they input 20 vectors. This 5, this is 2, this is say 10, whatever. So these indicate importance. So higher the scalar value, more the importance of the vector. So what they want is the 16 most, the top 16 most important vectors. So sorted in descending order. So what the authors saw is that the network was writing these vectors as per their importance to the external memory. So so they hypothesized that the network is doing that. So what the authors did was, So what the authors did is, just saying, let me write it now. So, supposing that this is the priority value for each of the 20 vectors, these are the locations L1, L2 till LN, capital N, N memory locations. And this is a linear function. So, what they did is they tried to predict the writing location. So, essentially, this means it that the memory is writing. So the memory is somehow. Network is somehow writing to those memory locations. Writing to the memory locations as a linear function of the priorities. That is what this essentially means. So, So they try to predict the locations at which the memory will write, and the observed memory locations came out to be approximately the same as the hypothesized memory locations. So basically their attempt with the experiment was also to see how the network is writing to locations, how it's generating programs for the tasks given to it. That's one observation that they made. So this is how they did priority sort. Okay, so yeah, these are the tasks that they attempted to do with NTMs. The authors have not released a code for NTMs. NTMs were like people have developed codes on codes for this. So yeah, this is pretty much it. There are actually many details associated with each task, but I think I will leave them alone. Any questions? Even I'm not very clear about all the working of the network, but I mean, the idea is good. Okay, so that's it.